Now that I've stirred up the assert faction in the playthrough, I need to build a spy drone to keep an eye on these enemy bases that are spawning. But in the process, I'm going to show you a very common problem with drones when it comes to having subgrids. Or really, any ship with subgrids. Because having subgrids can cause some really unusual ship behavior, lead to a lot of frustration, and just makes people abandon great build ideas because everything seems to be broken. But I'm going to show you how to fix that, and the build of this spy drone, right now. Let me start with what I wanted to do with this spy drone, so you have some context for the build and the problem. Now that I've started poking the bear with the assert faction and their spawning enemy bases, I wanted a fairly cheap to build small drone. I could take near each base, land it, and have it spy on the base so I could remotely see what's going on. Some bases are more defended than others. You can get ground robots patrolling inside and outside the bases, and they definitely can call in support drones, so I wanted to keep eyes on what's happening. Using a drone myself, I think, doesn't count as a player movement, so it doesn't spawn more bases and drones, if I'm really getting into a pinch. Plus, having a drone like this could come in real handy with other players and doing PvP. At the core, this drone just has the basics. A connector, a battery, a minimum complement of thrusters, and the other required blocks like gyroscopes and stuff. I'll go over the specifics in a minute, but I want to get right into this problem you can have with ships and drones and subgrids. Now with this build, I wanted a couple very specific things. I wanted an extendable landing pole with a simple mag plate to fix it to the ground and reduce any energy consumption, and a periscope with a camera that could rotate and look in virtually any direction. I also wanted the periscope to be off-center. A lot of my builds are very symmetrical, and I'm wanting to branch out and start working with more unusual shapes. So having this extendable and retractable periscope off to one side and a bit forward of the drone was a requirement. I was going to make this work. But now comes the problem. The piston to raise the periscope with the rotor and hinge for the camera creates subgrids on the ship. There's actually three total subgrids plus the main grid. One subgrid from the piston head to the base of the first rotor, a second subgrid from the rotor head through the block to the base of the hinge, and then a third one from the hinge head that attaches to the camera. Now the fundamental problem with subgrids is that they aren't accounted for into the physics of the ship while flying. That is, the thrusters and gyroscopes won't take into account the extra weight of subgrids. Now, this isn't a problem on a station or base that's attached to the ground and isn't overly troublesome on ships in the weightlessness of space, but it can be absolutely breaking on the ship builds that are being used in gravity. You can see that these subgrids are causing my ship to tilt off to one side. So if this is happening to you and you have subgrids, it's almost 100% the cause. Nothing may be wrong with your actual build of the game. With enough weight on the subgrids, or even where the weight is located, you can cause your ship to sink to the ground. Just slowly lose altitude. It won't hover properly. Both this tilting and sinking is a real pain, particularly when you're trying to land, to dock, or need some precision maneuvering of any kind. It's like having this unaccounted for weight pushing on the ship, and the thrusters and gyroscopes have no idea it exists. So they're only reacting to the mass on the main body of the ship where they're attached. But there is a fix. Now, some might be saying just to share inertia tensor on the subgrid blocks, but that will not fix this problem. The subgrids are still subgrids. And in fact, it can even make it worse by sharing some of that ship's mass onto the subgrid. There is a way to fix this though, or at least largely fix it, and that is with merge blocks. Merge blocks actually merge two grids together and essentially create one grid. So connecting the subgrids to your main grid will allow your thrusters and gyroscopes to act on all of it and eliminate those problems. If you set it up to be able to do so, you can separate those grids back into two whenever you want. But you've got to be a little particular with where the merge blocks are placed and making sure no other blocks are touching between the grids. I've got a much more detailed explanation on merge blocks and the main things you need to pay attention to in my video on merge blocks, which is also linked in the video's description. My plan with the merge blocks was to keep these subgrids all merged together while flying the drone. Then, after it landed and attached itself to the ground, I could unmerge the periscope and send up the subgrids with the rotors and camera to get that higher vantage point of viewing. What was going to be a quick 30 or 40 minute drone build I'd slapped together turned out into almost 2 days of building and reconstructing, redesigning, and failed attempts before I finally got something I was very happy with. I'll spare you all that trial and error, but fundamentally, what I thought I'd at least try is to merge all three grids together into one grid. This meant using three sets of merge blocks, and even though it created one of the most ungangly builds you've ever seen, I just wanted to prove a concept I could refine later. But it seemed to just be manufacturing a clang monster by adding more and more. After a bit, I figured out why I wouldn't be able to do the things the way I had planned. There was a second problem I needed to avoid with these merge blocks. By design of the game, you're not able to merge two parts of a given block that are designed to be placed as two separate grids. So for instance, with this piston, you're not able to merge the base of the piston to the head of the piston, or whatever that head is directly attached to. The piston and head are designed to be two separate grids. And when you try to merge things together, the game will do weird things to reject that attempt. In my case, in trying to merge the piston base to either the piston head or the base of the attached rotor, sometimes the base of the rotor would just detach from the piston head and fall to the ground. And in other cases, when I left the game and logged back in, the piston head would just be gone. The game deleted it because I was trying to do something incompatible. But there is a way around this that would still get me the most of what I wanted and what I needed to help stabilize this drone in flight. I could skip over one of the grids in this series and at least move a fair portion of the subgrid's mass to the physics of the main grid. Also, because the side of the piston head is an attachment point, I had to move the merge block assembly over to the corner to avoid anything touching that head. My troubles weren't quite over though. Between the piston and the rotor head exerting slight pressures on everything, merging them together created phantom forces and essentially started a spinning clang drive. To fix that, I simply detached and reattached the rotor head every time the merge blocks merged and unmerged, and automated that with the new event controller. With this setup, I was able to move the middle subgrid out of the equation and restore most of the stability back to the drone. There were still some subgrid pieces left that caused a small problem, but it was a vast improvement and any nuances were barely noticeable. These two merge blocks worked perfectly and also added to the aesthetic that I wanted for that asymmetrical design. The overall size of this thing is also extremely small, with the main body only measuring one large grid block. The top of the periscope and connector add a little to that though. It's also absolutely packed with the latest in drone and surveillance technology. It went through many iterations, but in its final form, it has two down thrusters and one pointing in all the other directions. A custom turret controller for the spy camera, some event controllers and timer blocks to automate things, cameras for flying and landing, and a lot of exposed lights to give the whole thing a very techie look. It also has a base set of AI grid blocks that I'll be setting up to automatically fly back to the base when the battery power gets down to something like 25%. Maybe even have it return back to the spy location after getting charged. We'll see. Now that I've got the main build completed and the subgrids worked out for manual flying, I'll continue to adjust and improve the automated aspects. If you've got something out of this deep dive into subgrid behaviors, give a like and subscribe, because we're continuing with the playthrough and heating things up with these enemy factions. We'll see how spicy we can get things in the next episode. See you next time.